Please, this was the first time I tried to pick up a job, I swear.
Listen, you took the money I offered you. It's a done deal. What do we got here?
Soliciting for prostitution. Booker.
No, please.
Name?
Jessica.
Jessica. Jessica what? Come on, honey, I need your last name.
Bennett.
What?
Bennett.
Jessica Bennett? Chief Bennett's daughter? Sam Bennett's little girl?
Mom, you know, we shouldn't be saying goodbye because this isn't over.
Yeah, it can't be over. Ethan hasn't even presented your defense yet.
Right. Did you see the way the jury was looking at me? They are already convinced that I tried to kill three people. And when they hear that I tried to leave the country with Julian.
Mom, but they haven't heard your side yet. And what about Julian? I mean, what if Julian comes up with something?
Well, yes, he may, but I'm resigned to the fact that I'm probably going to spend the rest of my life in prison. I'm going to miss all of you so much. And I'm so, so sorry.
So let me get this straight. What you're saying is that if I help you clear Eve of the charges of attempted murder, you'll give me anything I want?
That's what I said.
You must really love her.
I love her with all my heart.
Julian, what kind of thing is that to say to your wife?
The relationship you and I had was based on lust, not love, and you're my wife only because you blackmailed me. I've loved Eve for far too long to ever deny it.
Oh, my poor Pookie. To be so in love with a woman who's gonna rot away in jail.
But Rebecca, you can help me. You can save Eve from going to prison. If you will do that, I will give you anything you want.
Anything?
Yes, just name your price.
I wish I could be as sure as you are that Teresa's not going to try and sneak back in this house. I mean, you know she's completely obsessed with being near Jane and near you.
She won't. She's at home with her parents, and I know Martin and Pilar can convince her how dangerous it would be to come back here to be with Alistair.
Since when does Teresa listen to Pilar?
Gwen, look, all I know is that now that Teresa has gotten involved with Alistair, her parents are not going to let her out of their sight until they convince her that it would be stupid to come back here.
Well, I pray to God that you're right. Right now, I'm going to go check on Jane. And I want you to have a drink. You look spent.
I hope I'm right, too.
Now, I know that you're angry with me for leaving home the way I did, but your mother and I are trying to save you from a disaster.
Please, going back to that mansion to Alistair, that's only gonna end in tragedy.
Now, we know Alistair a lot better than you do, and whatever he promised you, it's not worth it.
He's gonna use you, Teresa. He's gonna take whatever he wants from you, and then he's gonna throw you out. Please don't let him do that to you, please!
Please, just keep your mouth shut about us, at least for a little while.
Okay. Hey, but I'm not promising forever. Just for a little while.
What if it does? My grandfather doesn't know won't hurt him.
But what he does know will. And will hurt you too.
Damn it.
I would hold the hand of the one who could lead me places, and kiss the lips of the one who could sing so sweet. And I would fly on the wings of the bird I knew could take me high. Breathe out, like in the afterlife.
I knew something that would help Eve stay out of prison, and I'm not saying that I do.
All right, fine. If you want to play this game, fine. If you know something.
Yes, if I knew something and I told you, you would give me anything I want?
That's what I'm offering.
So you would revise that little bone you threw me? That disgusting, insulting, measly divorce settlement?
Of course. You name your price. Anything in the world you want, I will give you. Beautiful Lee.
Julian, it's you.
I have a surprise for you.
Oh, goody. I love surprises. What is it?
Before I show you, I want to tell you how so very sorry I am that I ever doubted you, that I ever doubted us, that I doubted our love.
I always knew we could get along. It's just you weren't listening.
But I'm listening now, and I promise you I'll spend the rest of my life making you happy, my queen.
What is the least you can do? After all, you do owe me for getting Eve off those attempted murder charges.
Yes, I owe you anything your heart desires.
Goody. Now, where's my surprise?
Coming right up.
Remembered.
Rebecca! Listen, now, damn it. Talk to me. Tell me something so I can save Eve.
I can't apologize enough for what I've put you all through this past year. I know I should have told you the truth about my past. I know that now. And I'm sorry. I thought I was protecting.
Mom, it's okay. We know.
If I had told you the truth, then things would have turned out differently and you could have learned from my mistakes.
What we learned from you, Mom, is how to be decent people. We learned honesty and integrity.
They're right, you know. I mean, you're responsible for Whitney and Simone being the amazing women that they are.
We blamed you for our unhappiness, and that was wrong. But that was before, you know, and now we all can pray that you don't get convicted for something you didn't do.
Ken, we know you didn't try to kill anyone, no matter what Aunt Liz says.
No, babies, I didn't. But the only thing I care about now is your happiness. All of you, I want you to be happy. So is it Ray? Did she do or say something to hurt you?
We were in bed, talking. And, I thought everything was okay, but Ray didn't. She was so mean to me. Mom, my own girlfriend was so mean to me.
Simone, you follow your heart. No matter what anyone tells you, you can't be truly happy unless you follow where your heart leads.
I cannot believe that you kidnapped me. You had no right to do that.
It's because I love you.
You abandoned me. You abandoned Mama, and you never looked back. So I'm never gonna listen to a thing you say.
All right, fine. I'll leave. But for your own sake, please, listen to your mother.
You know what? You need to let go of this anger that you have towards your father.
Mom, I'm just gonna add it to the list.
Mira, Teresa, your father did what he thought he had to do at the time. But he is home now. And no matter what you say, he is your father, and you need the both of us.
to help save you from yourself.
I know what I'm doing.
Wow. Big words. You're a fool, Teresa. If you put your faith in Alistair, he will ruin your life. He will destroy you.
You'll pay, Fancy. You lied to me to be with this trash. So may his death be on your conscience before I take care of you. This should do it. Oh, wait, what am I doing? This is too easy. I've got a better idea.
What's the matter?
Nothing.
Let me see your arm. What the hell is this?
Hey, it's none of your business.
You're cutting yourself again, aren't you? Your father told me about it.
Yeah, well, it's none of his business either. Hey, do I get to make a phone call or what?
Sure. You want to call your father?
My father? No. No way. I'll just call someone else.
Rebecca, you will tell me what you know so I can save Eve.
I don't know anything.
You're a liar. You basically admitted that you were the one who put the poison in Liz's punch glass.
Mm-mm. You accused me and I said prove it.
You know I can't prove it, but you can tell me. Listen. We'll go to the prosecution, we'll cut a deal. You won't lose your freedom, and you can have whatever you want from me.
I don't know anything now, just leave me alone.
You won't tell me the truth, or I'll suck it out of you.
Julian, you're hurting me.
If you want to live, you'll tell me the truth.
I don't know anything. Oh. Help! Help! Julian's trying to kill me.
What's wrong with you?
I told you, Julian, he's trying to kill me.
Gotta be. Now it's wreck of a car.
What are you doing out here all?
Well, I couldn't sleep, and I just thought if I took a walk by the water that it would help me. You?
Well, you, Pilar, and I were having a discussion with Teresa, trying to convince her to leave the Crane Mansion and Alistair for good.
Oh, I hope you did. Martin, she's so young. Alistair will kill her spirit.
She wasn't much interested in what I had to say, so I left it with her mother. You know, maybe Pilar will be able to talk some sense into her.
I'm so sorry for what you're going through. I feel like I'm to blame because
Kevin,
I...
No, don't. You know what? We've talked this to death. You had to leave the hell of your marriage with Alistair, and I had to take you.
Well, I really should leave.
No, don't go. You know, not yet.
you can talk to your Blue, I'm not going to change my mind.
You are breaking my heart, Teresa. I can see that you have absolutely no respect for your father.
No, I don't, Mama. And why should I?
And the things that you said to me. You've never spoken to me like that before.
I'm sorry.
You have no respect for me. Am I no one to you,
no,
Teresa?
Mama. You're never gonna know how much you mean to me. I love you, and I do respect you. But I really need to do what is right for me.
This isn't what's right for you, Teresa. Why do you insist on throwing your life away like this?
I'm not.
If you obligate yourself to Alistair, you will never be happy, Teresa. Your life will be over.
You know what, Mama? You don't know what you're talking about.
I know what I'm talking about. Alistair has seduced you with his lies. He promised you that he'd get Jane back. He promised you, Ethan, are you really this stupid, this blind to believe that man?
He has power, Mama. He is powerful and he can help me get Jane and Ethan back.
Oh, yes, he's that powerful, Teresa. But my God, what price are you willing to pay? I haven't even told your father that he raped you because I'm afraid he'll go after Alistair and kill him.
It's none of Papa's business.
Is it none of my business? Is it? How can you even think to go back to that place where Alistair can have, oh my God, his way with you whenever he chooses?
Because Ethan and Gwen stole my daughter from me. And I'm gonna get her back, no matter what I have to do.
Mother, what in the world is going on?
I told you, Julian was trying to kill me.
Why? Just tell me what happened.
He was choking me. Oh, I probably have all these horrible bruises, and you know how easily I bruise.
Okay, I know that you are not his favorite person in the world, but you must have done something to provoke him.
She's breathing, isn't she? That's enough.
Julian, what happened? What'd she do?
Ask her.
Are you please gonna tell me what happened?
As you know, things are not looking very good for Eve because of Liz's testimony, and I guess I just didn't help much.
He tried to kill you because you testified?
Well, he's desperate to save Eve, and he thinks that I might know what happened.
Well, gee, you were the one who tried to poison Mrs. Strang.
Shh! Come here!
Tell me what he said.
All right. Julian somehow got it into his head that, well, that Eve didn't put the poison in Liz's cup. And then he also figured out that maybe Liz wasn't the intended victim, that Eve was, and that I did it.
How does he know the truth?
He doesn't know. He's just assuming it, but he accused me, and of course I denied it. But then, well then, he said that if I knew something that would keep Eve out of prison, that he would give me anything I want, anything.
Oh, Mother, you're not thinking what I think you're thinking.
Well, it is tempting.
Mother, are you insane? If you confess you were the one who tried to kill Eve, you're gonna go to prison for the rest of your life.
Julian, wait. Any luck with Rebecca?
No, sorry.
So am I.
But the jury hasn't heard your case for the defense yet, so let's not give up. I'm not.
No, I know. Julian, I'm gonna fight for Eve with everything I got, but I have to tell you, it does not look good.
I know that. But I will clear her of these charges against her, if it's the last thing I do.
Good luck.
I love you, son. And this beautiful baby. It looks just like you, and just like Whitney. Whitney, don't walk away. I need to talk to you.
Yes, Mom.
I know you know all this, but I just feel the need to say it again. If I had known that Chad was alive, I would have told you. Because then I would have been able to prevent you two from falling in love, but I didn't know. And I am so sorry.
I know you didn't. It's okay.
You think that you're a horrible person because you're in love with your half-brother. And you think that you've sinned against God. That's why you're going into the convent.
We did. Mom, we did sin against God.
But not intentionally. That's why I don't think the convent is the answer.
Mom, I've already made up my mind.
Please, honey, please think about it again, because a baby needs his mother, no matter what the circumstances of his birth. Please, Whitney, just throw away the guilt. Be a mother to your baby. Be a friend to your brother.
Well, Fancy, you and your low-life Lothario are gonna be really surprised.
Look, since this is your first defense, and since we all admire your old man so much, you could get off easy on this one.
Really?
Sure. All you have to do is give up your pimp.
You mean tell you his name?
Yeah. Give us a name and we'll make sure the judge goes easy on you.
No, I can't do that.
Why not? He's scum, Jessica.
You and I were both there. He ran out on you the moment I flashed my badge. Why are you protecting him? Just give us his name.
No, I can't let him get in trouble because of me.
What do you care? He doesn't give a damn about you.
Yes, he does. He loves me.
You think so? Well, suit yourself.
When are you going to admit that Ethan and Gwen didn't steal your baby? You lost her, Teresa, because you acted like a madwoman in court. You could have avoided all of this heartache.
I'm gonna get her back, and Alistair will help me.
Dios santo. How can you say that? He's never going to help you, Teresa, never.
Mama. Do you want me to be happy?
Don't be ridiculous. Of course I do.
Then just get out of my way. The only way I can be happy is if I have my daughter and Ethan.
Well, do you think that Ethan is going to want Alistair's whore?
If you align yourself with me, that means you approve of my methods, and Ethan's not going to go for that. He's going to think it's immoral behavior.
Ethan loves me, Mama. And one day we're going to be together. Now, please, just get out of my way. I'm going to the mansion now.
Teresa, por el amor de Dios, no hagas esto.
I should go.
Yeah, I know. It's just been a long time since I've seen you. I worry.
Oh, don't worry. Don't worry. I'm really fine.
Are you? I mean, you look well, but...
How are things going with Pilar, Martin? You're going to be renewing your vows soon, aren't you?
Yeah. It's gonna be like family again.
I hope so. You gave up so much to be with me in Mexico. You deserve to be happy.
And so do you. But you're still living in hell with the same man who raped and tortured you.
Well, it's not as bad as it seems. Because I'm near my son and my daughter and my grandchildren, and... I'm actually getting to know my son and daughter better and my grandchildren. I mean, that's the good part.
But that doesn't make up for living with Alistair Crane.
Maybe not.
Mm-hmm.
Mom, you're not telling me that I should go live with my brother, are you?
No. No, sweetheart. Just that you should have a life with your baby and with Chad as your brother.
But see, that can't happen, Mom.
Oh, Whitney, I want you to be happy, and I know that you can't be happy separated from your baby.
No, Mom, okay? It's not gonna work. No.
Julian, did you find anything that can help my mom?
Anything at all? No, I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry, my love. I thought I caught a snake in the grass, but it slithered away.
Mother, don't even think about it. You cannot tell Julian the truth.
Well, of course not. I mean, not unless I got a really good deal.
A good deal? Are you talking about a plea bargain with the DA? Because that is the only good deal you're going to get if you confess.
Of course that's what I'm talking about. No jail time and a really big fat check from Julian.
No jail time? Listen to me, do you seriously think Julian will be able to convince that vicious prosecutor, Grace Nancier, to just let you walk?
Look, honey, you of all people know how much power the Crane name carries.
Mother, this is an attempted murder charge. You are not gonna get a slap on the wrist, believe me.
Okay, but what if Julian and Ethan convince everybody that was an act of passion, you know? I mean, she is trying to steal my husband, for God's sake.
It is not gonna happen that way. And let's get one thing straight. If you decide to go ahead and do this crazy thing, I am not going to stand by your side.
What? Gwenny, you mean you wouldn't stand by your poor old mother?
No. Mother Teresa would easily be able to convince Ethan you're a criminal, and she'd be more determined than ever to prove that we were the ones who emailed the tabloids, and I could lose everything because of you. Please don't do it.
Oh, this should be very amusing.
That was amazing.
Unbelievable.
I can't believe how happy I am. Are you happy, Noah?
Delirious.
You're not mad about keeping a secret from my grandfather?
Look, how could I be mad about anything? When I look at you, you're so beautiful.
So are you.
You are.
I don't want anything to spoil it. I just can't tell my grandfather about us yet. But I am his favorite. You'll see. He'll come around eventually.
Whatever you say.
On your feet! Come on, hurry up, get dressed.
Look, did we break some kind of law or something, officer?
What do you think?
We did. We didn't realize it, and we're sorry.
Just shut up and come with us. Hurry it up, miss.
I'm hurrying,
hey.
Okay?
Look, is this because we're kind of undressed? I recognize that this is not a nude beach or anything like that, but look, we're covered up and we're the only people out
there. Enough already. Just shut up and come with us.
All right. Listen. I'm gonna give you one last chance to drop a dime on your pimp. What's his name? Tell me and you could walk away.
No, I won't.
Well, it's your life. What's left of it?
Hey, how you doing? I'm here to bail her out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That was quick. We just found out how much it is.
Yeah, I know. It's all there. No problem.
Sign here.
Sure. There you go.
Okay, you can go. Take care of yourself, Jessica.
Want some?
What are you doing? Trying to get me busted?
No. That's why I warned you. I was afraid the undercover cop would recognize you.
You know, it's lucky for you he didn't. You are so stupid. I don't know why I bother with you. Now, let's go.
Well, I have to get back to the convent. Good luck in court tomorrow, Mom. I'll be praying for you, okay?
Thank you, sweetheart.
I should go, too. Should put Miles to bed.
Me, too. You guys must have things to talk about.
Thank you all for coming. This is it. No more goodbyes.
I'll be there tomorrow.
So will I.
You all right?
Nothing hurts like seeing your children in pain.
Nothing hurts me more than seeing you in pain. I'm so very sorry I failed you. But I won't give up. I swear to you, I will never give up.
Hey. What's wrong? Is Jane okay?
Jane is fine. She's sound asleep.
You look upset.
Well, I just ran into my mother upstairs. You know, as usual, she was being her annoying, crazy self. She really, really gets on my nerves sometimes.
Yeah, I hear that. Tell you what, I have a cure for it, though. I got a cure. Come here.
You're amazing, you know that?
Mm-hmm.
To even think about me when you were under so much stress from Eve's trial.
Let me tell you something. Helping you helps me. I don't want you to worry. Everything's gonna be fine with Jane. I promise you.
Gwenny's right. I can't tell Julian or anyone else that I accidentally poisoned Liz when I was trying to kill Eve. Because if anyone is gonna go to jail for a very long time, it ain't gonna be me.
So your hunch didn't pay off, huh?
No, but I tell you, I'm more convinced than ever that this person can save you. I just have to keep hammering away, and I will, I promise you. I'll be there with you every step of the way.
Jessica?
Don't you talk to her. Don't talk
Jessica,
to her.
Jessica, Spike, leave her alone.
Oh, geez, you again. How many times do I have to tell you to stay away from my woman? Jessica doesn't want anything to do with you, and you know damn well I don't.
Well, I don't care what you want, jerk. Leave her alone. Let her go. Hey, Spike, no! Don't hurt her!
Shut up. Hey, you got work to do tonight. You cost me a bundle, and you're gonna make up for it. Now move it. Let's go.
Jessica, come back. Just don't go with him. Jessica!
We should not be here like this. It's not fair to Pilar.
I know.
You made a commitment to her. You have to keep it. I have to go.
Still worried, are you?
Honey, I can't help it. You know, I was watching Jane sleeping, and she's so beautiful and happy, and I worry that she's gonna be taken away from us.
She won't be. I promise you, things are gonna get better from now on.
Okay. I mean, they have to, right? With Teresa gone, things have to get better. Okay.
So sorry to disappoint you, but I'm back, and I'm not going anywhere.
Look, this is crazy, you guys. You can't arrest us for being on the beach at night.
Maybe it was the fire. If there's some kind of fine for making a fire on the beach, just tell us. I'll be happy to pay it.
Whose car is this? It's mine. Why? Look, my license and the registration are up to date.
We found these in the glove compartment. An unlicensed handgun and cocaine. There's half a pound here. You're selling it.
What?
Well, those aren't mine, all right? Look, I don't own a gun, first of all. And second of all, I don't do drugs, let alone sell them. This is all just a big mistake, all
right? Yeah, and you made it. Turn around. You have the right to remain silent. If you choose to give up that right, anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
You can't arrest him! This is a big mistake!
No mistake, Fancy. You're going to pay in ways you never knew were possible. I'm going to bury the whole Bennett clan and enjoy myself while I'm doing it.
I'm going to be going to prison for the rest of my life.
The way you just hugged Chris, you haven't forgotten about Luis already.
Meet your new cellmate, Thumper, courtesy of Alistair Payne.